After I did the Nylon Curtain and we went on the road, I wanted to do something which was 180 degrees in the other direction. I had gotten divorced and I started dating these different women. I was going out with models and I was a rock star, you know, a single guy who was a rock star. I was like amazed at my good fortune at the time. And I started dating Christie Brinkley at the time too, and started writing songs about these experiences. I kind of felt like a teenager all over again. All those songs that I remembered from the early 60s, the R&B songs and the Four Seasons and the Motown music and soul music. And that's how I felt. And you don't fight that. When you're going to write, you write what you're feeling. And I didn't fight. I said, the material was coming so easily and so quickly, and I was having so much fun doing it. I was kind of reliving my youth. And I just had fun. I had a great time making this recording. I wrote a song called Easy Money, which was sort of like a Wilson Pickett, James Brown R&B track, and I sang it live with the full band. It was so much fun. The rest of the song started coming real fast. I wrote it in the studio. I wrote most of this album in the recording studio. I think within 6 weeks, I had written most of the material on the album. And it wasn't to have hit records. Again, who thought that, you know, songs that sounded like the late 50s, early 60s, a cappella, oh, For the Longest Time is another song on here. Who would have figured they could ever be hit records in the 80s? And they were. For the Longest Time was an a cappella doo-wop song that became a big hit. Uptown Girl was an homage to the Four Seasons, for Frankie Valli and the Four Seasons. And it became a hit record. Who would have thought there would be a hit record by the Four Seasons in the 80s? That's where I was at.